What is FileZilla? FileZilla is cross-platform FTP software. FileZilla is available for free as open source software. It contains both a client and server. It has support for FTP, SFTP, and FTPS. It supports Microsoft Windows, Linux, and Mac. Its features include upload and download bandwidth limits, compression, encryption, and message logging. Let's download and install a FileZilla server. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, enter filezilla-project.org and press enter. Under Quick Download Links, click the Download FileZilla Server button. Under Windows, click the Download Now button. On the Download Information bar, click the Run button. This will download the file and then automatically start the installer. The FileZilla installer window will open. On the License Agreement screen, read the License Agreement, and then click the I Agree button. On the Choose Components screen, leave Standard selected, and then click the Next button. On the Choose Install Location screen, click the Next button. On the Startup Settings screen, leave Install as Server Started with Windows selected. Under Please Choose a Port, choose the port you want to use for the listening port. This is the port to connect to the admin interface. We will leave the default of 14147, and then click the Next button. On the Startup Settings screen, leave the default of Start if User Logs On, Apply to All Users selected, and then click the Install button. On the Installation Complete screen, click the Close button. We left the option selected to automatically start the server management interface. By default, the administration password is blank. Now click the OK button. You will then see it say Logged On. Let's now set up the server. Click on the Edit menu, and then Settings. General Settings. The default settings are fine for this screen. Looking by listen on these ports, we can see that it is set to use port 21. This is the standard FTP port. Welcome message. Here you will set the message users will get when they log on to the server. Let's enter a simple message of welcome to my server. IP bindings. Here you can set which IP addresses on the server it will bind the FileZilla server to. By default, it'll use a star, which represents all adapters. IP filter. This is used to block out specific IP addresses. If you have problem users or hackers trying to penetrate your server, you can block them out here. Miscellaneous. Let's place a check next to Start Minimize. This will start the server directly into the system tray. You won't have to close down the application when it pops up every time you start the computer. Admin Interface Settings. Here you can set allowed and denied IP addresses or ranges. By default, all addresses are allowed. Let's click the Select Change Admin Password, and then enter a new password twice. Here I'm just entering password for the password. Logging. It's a good idea to keep track of what's going on your FTP server. Let's click to select Enable Logging to File. If you have a low usage server, leaving Log All to FileZillaServer.log selected is probably fine. You can select Limit Log File Size to, and then it will split the file off into another file when it reaches that threshold. This helps view very large files that would hang a system. If you have a high usage server, you'll probably want to select Use a Different Log File each day. The log files are stored in the FileZilla installation folder, inside a folder named Logs. By default, this path is C, Program Files x86, FileZilla Server, Logs. Speed limits. This is where you can set maximum download and upload speeds for the server. If the server is heavily used and you want to make sure there is enough bandwidth available for all your other internet needs, you can limit the speeds here. Auto ban. Not to be confused with the auto ban. You may want to enable autoban to prevent someone from hacking into your server. We'll click to enable automatic bans. Now the default setting for autoban is that after 10 failed login attempts, it will ban the user for 1 hour. Now just click the OK button to apply all settings. Let's close out of the admin interface and then log back in with our new password. Now we can open it back up by double-clicking on the FileZilla server icon on the desktop, or by clicking the Windows Start button, All Programs, FileZilla Server, and then FileZilla Server Interface. I'll enter our new password of password, and then click the OK button. Now the server address here, I'm putting in the default of 127.0.0.1, which is just pointing the server back at itself. It's a lookback address. You could also use the actual IP address of the server if you like, or you could use localhost here. Now when it logs back in, by default here it is closing to the system tray. Let's click to expand the icons, and we'll see that we have our FileZilla server icon here. To be able to see that at all times, click on the Customize button. Find FileZilla server in the list. And then in the drop-down, select Show Icon and Notifications. And then click the OK button. It'll now permanently show up down here in the system tray as long as it's running. We'll double-click on this to open up the interface. Now we could just create a user to access the system, but we're also going to create a group to use with base settings for all our users. Let's click the Edit menu, and then Groups. To create a new group, click on the Add button. On the Add User Group window, enter a name and click the OK button. We'll call this group Normal Users. General. Make sure Enable Access for Users inside this group is selected. Shared Folders. This is where we set the folders we want to give users access to. Under the Directories pane, click the Add button. A Browse for Folder window will open. Browse to and select the folder you want to share. I'm going to browse to my X drive, and I have an FTP folder here, and I have a folder set up for my normal users. I'm going to click OK. We only have one folder in the list, so it's already our home folder. This is the folder the users will be dropped into when they log in. There is an H next to the listing showing that this is the home folder. If you have more than one folder, you would click the Set as Home Directory button. For each directory, we have permissions for files and directories. By default, users can list the contents of the directory and subdirectories, as well as the ability to read the files. You can give the users the ability to create or delete directories, as well as write or delete files. Speed limits. We already saw where we could set speed limits for the server as a whole. Here we can set download and upload speed limits for this user's group. IP filter. Here you set addresses not allowed to access the server when logging into this group. For instance, if you had an accounting department and you only wanted people from the accounting department to be able to access it, you could then go in and put in all the addresses for all the other departments here, ensuring that only people within the accounting department would be able to access it. Once everything is set up correctly, click the OK button. Now all that did was create a group. There isn't an actual account we can use to log into the server yet. To do this, we need to create a new user. Now click on the Edit menu, and now Users. The Users window will open. We can see that the Users menu that opens is exactly the same as the Groups window we looked at previously. Under Users, click on the Add button. The Add User Account window will open. Enter a name for the new user. Let's name this user User1. Under where it says User should be a member of the following group, we can see it currently says None. Leaving it set to None will create a new user that is not in any group. This means that all the settings for this user come from the user settings. If we click the drop-down, we can see our group Normal Users. Let's select this, and then click the OK button. If we look at the boxes on the General tab, we can see that some of the boxes are filled with blue. This means that they are inheriting the permission from their parent group, which is Normal Users. If we click the box next to Enable Account one time, it will deselect it. If we click it one more, it'll put a check in the box. The check means we're going to override the group settings and are enabling it at a user level. The blank box means we are overriding the group settings and disabling it at a user level. Now let's click it one more time to enable it at the group level. Every single user should have a password. Click to select password. Again, we'll enter password. Shared folders. In addition to the directories that we have in the group settings, we can add additional folders. By default, if we did nothing more, this user would still be able to access the FTP folder, normal users directory from the group, even though that isn't shown here. Now let's click the Add button under Shared Folders. On the Browse for Folder window that opens, we're going to browse to and select a folder to share again. I'm going to go back to my X drive, the FTP folder, and now I'm going to share out this private folder. Click the OK button. This is going to be a user with special access to this folder. Let's give them rights by enabling everything. Now the user has access to this new folder, but would not be able to navigate out of the home directory into the private folder yet. To be able to change to this folder once we log in, we need to set an alias for this folder. We're going to right-click on it and select Edit Aliases. Here we can enter any name we want for the alias, as long as it's preceded by a forward slash. I'm going to put in forward slash, private, link. Now remember here, it is essential that you have a forward slash or it won't work. Click the OK button. If you want to, you can also adjust speed limits and IP filters on a per user basis. Now let's just click the OK button to create this new user. Let's connect to the server now with the built-in Windows FTP client. I'll be creating a future tutorial about using the FileZilla client. But for simplicity this time, I'm just going to use the Windows FTP client. Now we'll click on the Windows Start button. All Programs. Accessories. And then Command Prompt. At the Command Prompt, we're going to type FTP space localhost. This is going to use the FTP command to connect to the localhost, which again is our computer. You could also use 127.0.0.1 here, or the actual IP address of your computer that the server is running on. Press Enter. Here we can see the welcome message we set before of welcome to my server. We'll enter user 1 for the username. And then we're going to enter a password for the password. We are now in the home directory from our group settings. We can't see what folder this is on the server for use. It is just the root folder defined as forward slash. Let's list the directory contents here by typing in dir and pressing enter. Dir is the command for a directory listing in FTP. Here we can see the normal users.txt file I created so that we would know that we were in the normal users folder from the group. We also have the link, private link, that links to the private folder we shared in our user settings. Let's go ahead and enter the private directory by typing in cd space private link. Cd is the FTP command for change directory. Let's list the contents again with dir. In this folder we can see the private.txt file showing we are in the private folder. Now let's create a new folder to test our write permissions here. Now when we set this up, the normal user folder, we only had access to read the files. In the private folder, we have access to create files and to delete files. Now in the private directory, let's go ahead and create a new folder to test our write permissions. We'll enter the command mkdir space test. This is just going to try and make a new folder named test. Mkdir is the command for make directory. And then push enter. Let's type in dir again so we can see what we did. And now we can see we have a new folder here called test. Let's back out to our home folder. To move back, you type in cd space dot dot or period period and press enter. Cd is the command to change directory Dot dot tells it to go to the previous or upstream folder. Now we're back in the normal directory. Remember, we only have access to read the files here. Let's again try and make our test directory. And we can see we get a permission denied error. We can see now that we get a message saying can't create directory, permission denied. So it looks like all our permissions are set up correctly. You should now have FileZilla downloaded and installed, a group and a user created, and have a good idea of how to manage file and directory access on your server.